Off on another adventure, are we?
If I transfigure my poor toad into a goblin one more time, I think he's going to insist he stay that way.
How nice to see you, my young friend.
Thank you.
Revelio. Revelio. Who lived here, I wonder?
Perhaps I shall scout around Fellcroft.
Well, if we're talking beasts, if the Nephilim is the real commodity, surely you agree?
I just want to point out, I don't really have any evidence those guys were doing anything wrong. They were just walking around here and I attacked them.
Revelio. Solves that. Revelio. I should investigate. Lumos. Yeah. Revelia. Let me enter.
Hey, hey, who are you in my 100-acre woods?
Rebellion. Revelia. We have Ranrok to blame.
Thank you.
my fault you're a deadly great spider. What are you up to now? Revelio. Leviosa.
Oh, so tired.
Sound?
Your time to regret that.
Here I find you. rebellion.
Something's
wrong. Let's get.
Confringo! Leviosa! I did it. And an Ashwinder, no less. Repairer. Here's a pleasant surprise. Rebellion. Confringo. Rebellion. Confringo! Revelio. Merlin himself would be proud. Rebellion.
Hey, dear.
Leviosa. Revelio.
Don't worry, kitty. I saved you from the people that wanted to keep you locked up by locking you in my bag.
Seems a pleasant enough little place. Mind now, demiguys. Revelio. Hello, Mr. Semi.
What can I do for you?
Any whispers going about the town?
There's a thief on the loose by the name of Katrin Haggerty. She's an Ashwinder. She's stealing everything that's not nailed down, and people have had enough. Katrin's hiding in a camp just southwest of town.
Yeah, I can't stand people that just go into people's house and start stealing their shit.
What do you have for sale?
Anyway, here's a bunch of shit I got somehow.
Hope to see you again sometime.
Hello, Mr. Semi.
What can I do for you?
Any whispers going about the town?
You may have noticed we have a bit of a rivalry with Upper Hogsfield. Not much to it, but we're still the better of the two Hogsfields. Better than most other places, too.
Any whispers going about the town?
A goblin called Pergit is causing a bit of a stink. His gang is attacking traveling vendors, and now business is suffering everywhere. It would be nice if someone would do something about it. No one wants to pick a fight with a band of goblins, though. Which means he's free to do what he wants down in Coral Ruins.
That will be all. Thank you for your time.
Thank you.
can bring us. Here. Take her. Stupefy. Ravenia.
I've always said that travel broadens the mind. Ravenia. Stupid.
I know a Merlin trial when I see one. Infringer! You're so tricky after all, Merlin.
Thinking in terms of good and evil merely indicates a limited imagination, in my opinion.
Days are over. Alohomora. Revelia. Thank you. Revelio. Let's see what's up your sleeve this time, Merlin. Lumos. These Merlin trials won't get the best of me.
What the hell are you doing?
Rebellion. Not sure how I'd fare in a little place like this.
I don't know about centaurs, but there hasn't been a dragon in history worth losing a hair over.
My advice when dealing with untoward matters is...
What do we have here? A little more. Revelio.
goblet born with the sorted flayer only.
I'd be terribly grateful if you could help me and my friend with a time-sensitive...
You sound as if you could use some help.
Oh, yes, I could. Eddie Thistlewood's the name. A dear friend of mine in Feldcroft is at his wit's end due to the relentless attacks on his hamlet by Ranrock and his loyalists. I sent 2 crates of Chinese chomping cabbages to help, but they've gone missing.
You sent crates of cabbages to battle Ranrock's loyalists?
I did indeed. You see, I know plants, and I believe the goblins will be so irritated by the onslaught of ferocious vegetation, they'll simply leave Feldcroft alone. I wonder if you might track the 2 crates down and deliver their contents to my friend Bernard Ndiaye. I simply can't leave my shop at present.
I'd absolutely love to.
Why would the goblins target Feldcroft?
My friend Bernard says they've been seen in the area for a while. He seems to think they're looking for something, but lately they've become more aggressive.
Could you not grow or buy more Chinese chomping cabbages?
I suppose I could, but that would take time. Time we do not have, what with Ranrock's thugs posing new threats every day. Besides, it's the principle of the matter. I grew those cabbages, and they are extraordinary.
Dude, it takes... Dude, it takes like 10 minutes to grow a cabbage.
Any idea where I might find the crates?
Yes. From what I hear, one was spotted south of Feldcroft. The other, so I hear, is south of Brockborough near the river.
Very well, sir. I shall keep an eye out for 2 crates of Chinese chomping cabbages.
Oh, thank you. I shall let Bernard know he might be receiving those cabbages after all.
What do you have for sale?
I'm convinced that Feldcroft will be much safer with Chinese chomping cabbages defending them.
Sounds like Feldcroft's in trouble. Perhaps I should try to help.
I'll be able to put that to good use. Thank you. I hope to see you again soon.
Wonder who lives here. That crate of Chinese chomping cabbages is somewhere in this camp.
You'll regret regret crossing my path.
What's up, bitches? I'm here for...
I'll never meet a beast.
Who got some salad for me?
You'll have to fight eventually. No!
You've done to helpless beasts. What do you have in store for me this time? Ravenia. That's one crate in hand. I only need one more. Repair it.
Aversion to the dark arts merely highlights an immaturity of thinking in my mind.
They come after me. I'll kick them like a...
Bring up!
Let me Everything's all right now.
Yes, he's much better in my cage than that cage.
Ravenia. Rebellion. Ravenia. Seems a pleasant enough little place.
How nice to see you, my young friend.
An intruder!
You can see why Feldcroft needs... Ranrock's loyalists are hiding out near Feldcroft. They must have the other crate of Chinese champion packages.
You won't last long.
I won't rest.
Dead.
Are you quite finished?
Confringo.
No! No! No!
That's all of the crates of Chinese chomping cabbages. I'd better go and see Mr. Thistlewood's friend in Felcroft.
Hello there. Do you have the special delivery from my dear friend, Eddie?
Hello, Mr. Ndai. Eddie Thistlewood sent me.
Yes, he told me to expect you. Do you have the Chinese chomping cabbages?
I have them right here.
Marvellous. This will go a long way towards protecting the hamlet from Ranrock's loyalists. The same foul curs who, I'm willing to guess, intercepted them in the first place. Along with Rookwood's lot. Feldcroft owes a debt of gratitude to you and Eddie. Thank you for your help.
Do you have any idea why the goblins are attacking Feldcroft?
No clue. I used to think it was because of its strategic location, but now it's as if they were looking for something. I will admit, however, that I don't know what they could possibly be looking for.
How do you and Eddie know each other?
We met at Hogwarts. Been friends and business associates ever since. I wasn't surprised to get his owl about his Chinese chomping cabbage scheme. He was always one to go out of his way to help another.
What do you have for sale?
At last, some reinforcements. Hopefully this is enough to thwart the goblins. A pleasure doing business with you. Have I mentioned you're welcome to stop by any time?
Revelio. Avelio. Not sure how I'd fare in a little place like this. Revelio.
You made it.
Enjoying the view?
Keeping an eye on things. Feldcroft isn't what it used to be. No one has felt safe here since Ranrock's loyalists took a peculiar interest in that castle over there. Rookwood Castle. My uncle Solomon is a former Aura and refuses to look into it, even after Anne was cursed by one of them. Possibly with a wand, no less.
I heard a goblin refer to wizard kind as wand carriers. Are goblins forbidden from carrying wands?
Precisely. That's why I'm on the hunt for answers. If I'm to cure her, I need to understand what happened to her. Anne was always the most mischievous of the three of us. Which is saying something, knowing me and Ominous. I'm hoping a surprise visit from me and a new friend from Hogwarts will help lift her spirits. Bring back the Anne I used to know. Come on, I'll take you to my uncle's. This way. Feldcroft used to be a lot livelier. With Ranrock's lot wandering about all the time, everyone stays out of sight. Here we are. My sister should be just inside.
Aha!
Sebastian, where did you...
Is that what I think it is?
We've been over this, boy. Hey. Shrivelfix cannot reverse a curse. Nothing can. The sooner you accept that reality, the better.
But we haven't tried everything.
There is no cure! When will you accept that?
Never! I can never accept it.
Now look what you've done.
I'm sorry.
Leave.
I'm sorry you had to see that. If you don't mind, I just need a moment alone.
Poor Sebastian. Not the visit he'd hoped for.
I'm sorry about earlier. Those bouts of pain are difficult to bear.
Are you all right, Anne? I didn't mean to intrude.
You didn't, truly. And I'm all right. The pain from this curse comes in bouts, and often suddenly. It's not anyone's fault. It's nice to meet you, by the way. You must be the new fifth year Sebastian told me about.
I am. Sebastian and I met during a rather lively duel in Defense Against the Dark Arts.
Oh, dear Professor Hecate. She's a powerful witch. And she knows how to keep students like my brother, and me, in line. I do miss Hogwarts. but I wouldn't mind being in Feldcroft, really, if it wasn't so dreary now. Between the goblins at the castle and my uncle fighting with Sebastian whenever he's home, it's not the cozy retreat it once was.
Sebastian mentioned something about your uncle being an ex-Aura, but refusing to go after Ranrock's loyalists. I must say, I wasn't prepared for him to be as angry as he was.
Uncle Solomon is frustrated by what happened to me, and by Sebastian for thinking he can fix it. They both mean well, I know they do, but my uncle is right. This curse cannot be undone. I can feel it. Sebastian cannot take away my pain. Perhaps you can help him to understand that.
I'm afraid it's really up to Sebastian, and his mind seems to be made up.
I can only hope he realizes the futility of his search for a cure soon. I'm getting tired. I should probably rest. Thank you for stopping by. I wish you well.
That boy will fray my last nerve.
Excuse me, Mr. Sallow.
Oh, yes, Sebastian's friend. I apologize on behalf of my nephew. He doesn't know when to stop. I was about to check on Anne. Did I see you come from the house? How is she?
She's all right. She said she was going to rest.
Nothing can be done for her.
It could be that you've not yet discovered the cure.
Ah, you sound like Sebastian, thinking you know better than the healers at St. Mungo's.
Perhaps the healers don't know everything, sir. Sebastian is single-mindedly focused on finding a way to help his sister. If there is a cure, he will find it.
Your faith in Sebastian is misplaced. Some sort of dark magic cursed Anne, and the goblins aren't likely to explain themselves any time soon. Giving her hope is cruel. The only thing to do now is keep Anne comfortable and stay out of the Loyalists' way.
With all due respect, sir, hope could keep Anne's spirits up.
You may mean well, but I know what's best for Anne and Sebastian. They are my stubborn brother's children. Especially Sebastian. If you really want to be of help, you'll make sure Sebastian does what he should do, not what he wants to do. He's no idea the harm he could do if he doesn't stop. I hope you remember what I've said. Good day.
I ought to see how Sebastian's faring.
Why will he not listen to me? She's my sister.
How are you doing, Sebastian?
You got a first-hand glance at what I'm dealing with. I apologize for my uncle.
I'll admit, I wasn't expecting him to be so angry.
He's always angry. He's been angry since my parents died. After Anne was hurt, he only grew worse. It's as though he blames me somehow, always calling me my father's son, as if that's an insult. I'm the one trying to help her. He's simply given up.
Both Anne and your uncle seem genuinely convinced that nothing more can be done for her.
I refuse to believe that. Anne's pain is more than physical. It has changed her entirely. I miss my sister. And I'm going to get her back. Come with me. I need to show you where it happened. Ranrock's loyalists are capable of so much more than people realize. They should not be underestimated.
Well, I mean, I've killed like a dozen
of
them,
so... All the debris you see is from whatever's going on at that abandoned estate. They've been digging for something. Up there, on that plateau, is where they cursed Anne. This way.
How much longer are we expected to dig through this rubble? Ranrock knows what he's doing. It's an honor to be a part of it. Only good wizard is a dead wizard in my book.
Oh, I have. Hi there. Hello?
No! I'm going to say. Let's get this out of the way. Rather I'm wise coming back this way.
You won't get away with that.
I'm a goblin, not a toy. You are postponing the inevitable. You've made your last mistake.
I confess, that was a bit more than I bargained for. I tried to warn you.
Those loyalists deserved what they got.
Couldn't agree more. This is where it happened. We smelt smoke in the middle of the night. When we looked outside, flames were shooting from the estate. Before my uncle and I could stop her, Anne rushed out, racing towards the fire, worried someone had been hurt. She came face to face with a horde of goblins, frantically trying to stamp out the flames. Suddenly, an icy voice drifted out from somewhere in the smoke. Children should be seen and not heard. A blinding blast followed. They didn't even give her a chance to run.
It sounds as if the Loyalists attacked Anne without cause.
I wouldn't put it past them, but I'm convinced that they were trying to hide something. It may be grasping at billywigs, but I keep thinking that there might be something here that could lead me to whoever cursed Anne. Might be the only way to learn what type of magic harmed her, which could help me find a cure.
Perhaps you're right. The Loyalists are everywhere, but they do seem to be spending a lot of time here, and it's likely they're hiding something.
And at Rookwood Castle. Shall we have a look around? They seem to have set up camp here for a specific reason.
Revelio.
They have stations for everything. I've heard goblin dig sites like these are popping up everywhere.
It's a wonder the Ministry isn't doing more. Whose home was this?
Bit abandoned long since I've lived here. Rumor was a Hogwarts professor lived here once, centuries ago. But that's all I ever heard. It might be worth taking a closer look at the house itself.
This well looks familiar.
Revelio!
Sebastian! I've seen this before. The house, the well, the view.
What do you mean? When?
Give me a moment. I'll explain in a second. Bastion, over here. Do you think this was damaged by the fire the night that Anne was cursed?
Could be. But it looks to me as though this was intentional.
Confringo! Sebastian, this house did belong to a Hogwarts professor hundreds of years ago.
Who? What do you...
I found a pensive that day in the restricted section with a memory that showed this house. There was a little girl and a drought. The keepers have shown me other memories as well. The girl became a Hogwarts professor. Her name was Isadora Morganock. She was one of the keepers.
The keepers? Like in Quidditch? And you found a pensive in the library? I'm not following you.
I realize it's a lot to take in. I'm not even sure I understand it all yet. And no, not like Quidditch. They call themselves keepers because they're protecting some type of knowledge. It all has to do with the vault at Gringotts.
Let me see if I've got this straight. You have Ranrok and Rookwood after you because of something you found at Gringotts where you ended up via a portkey. You can see traces of an ancient magic that you think Ranrok is trying to harness. And now you've been witnessing memories left by keepers. Oh, and this house belonged to a Hogwarts professor who was one of these non-Quidditch keepers hundreds of years ago. If I didn't know you, I think you were pulling my leg.
It is all a bit much, isn't it, when you put it like that? The point is, we both have good reason to search this house. You for answers about what happened to Anne, and me for answers about the keepers.
Look at this.
Someone piled this here for a reason. Is it blocking something?
Only one way to find out. Huh, a stairwell.
Revelio.
Why bother blocking a stairwell?
There might be something here worth a closer look.
They've left all of this simply strewn about. Tells me they're after something bigger.
Journal entry of Isadora's. I should hold on to this. Seems these journal entries are from Isadora's travels. Revelio. Revelio. You're not going to believe this. I can see the Undercroft.
What? A daydream? Because that happens to me too.
I know it sounds strange.
Honestly,
but...
nothing you say sounds strange to me anymore.
Fair enough. I can see the Undercroft through this stone wall, as though it's a window. This has happened before.
I'm listening.
I think it's to do with my ability to see traces of ancient magic.
But you said you didn't really understand it, and that you couldn't wield it.
That's true, and I'm still not sure what it all means.
Except I've been wielding it all day.
Is that my ability allows me to travel through these windows, I see.
Wait. We can get straight to the Undercroft, from here. Ominous will be flawed.
We can, but perhaps best not to tell anyone else about this for now. Even Ominous.
Understood. Well then, invisible, secret, ancient magic passageway? Here we come. I'm tempted to hold my breath.
Revelio.
Why would the door lead us here?
Sebastian, look. Why hide a triptych here?
Seems as if something's missing.
A note. Let's have a look.
Anything helpful in the note?
A rune symbol. I've seen similar symbols used by the keepers.
I've been thinking. A keeper lived in that house centuries ago, and Ranrok and his lot have been searching there. You said that goblins may be wielding some form of this ancient magic. Do you think Anne was cursed by ancient magic?
I can't be sure, of course, but I don't think so. I didn't see any traces of it around your sister.
Very well. But that doesn't mean it's not ancient magic. There's still so much we don't know about it.
True. Perhaps this triptych will lead us to answers.
Then we'll have to unravel what this all means. But now I need to see Ominous. Don't worry, I won't tell him anything. Did I mention that, apparently, Salazar Slytherin had a secret scriptorium here, in Hogwarts?
You did not. Sounds worth looking into. Any idea where in the castle?
No idea. Ominous just learned of it. I'll let you know what I find out. I had no idea our visit to Cian would unfold into all of this. My head's an utter mess. But I'm glad you told me everything you did. I'll be in touch. Till then.
Revelio.
Meet me near the ruins of Falbarton Castle. After dark. Do not tell anyone. Settle yourself. I mean you no harm.